Hello friends, in this presentation we will be discussing about pitch factor and winding factor. So first of all, what is pitch factor? Pitch factor is also known as coil span factor, and it is defined as the ratio of EMF generated in a short pitch coil to the EMF generated in a full pitch coil. It is denoted by letter Kp, and its value is always less than unity. Therefore, as per the definition of pitch factor, Kp will be equal to EMF generated in short pitch coil divided by EMF generated in a full pitch coil. Let us now derive the formula for pitch factor. So figure here shows a short pitch coil in which the two coil sides are separated by a space angle of 180 degree minus zeta. This separation between these two coil sides is known as coil span, which is equal to 180 degree minus zeta here. Let us assume E1 is the EMF generated in this coil side and E2 is the EMF generated in this coil side. So the EMF available at the terminal of the coils will be equal to the resultant of EMF generated in this coil side and EMF generated in this coil side. So let us draw phasor diagram of this EMF generated in the coil side. Here E1 is the reference phasor. Since E1 and E2 are the EMF generated in the two coil sides of the coil having according angle of zeta, therefore E1 and E2 are shown to be separated by an angle of zeta here. ER is the resultant EMF available at the terminals of the coil. So obviously ER will be the phasor sum of E1 and E2, which can be calculated by using triangle law of addition of two vectors. So ER will be equal to root over E1 square plus E2 square plus 2 E1 E2 cos zeta. Since the magnitude of EMF generated in both the coil sides of the short pitch coil are equal, therefore we are replacing here E1 and E2 by E. So ER will be equal to root over E square plus 2 E square cos zeta, and if you solve this equation, you will get EMF available at the terminals of coil to be equal to 2E cos zeta by 2. So this is the EMF available at the terminals of the short pitch coil. Let us now calculate the EMF generated in a full pitch coil. As we know, the cording angle for a full pitch coil is equal to 0. So if we put 0 in place of zeta, then the EMF generated in full pitch coil will be equal to 2E cos 0 by 2. This means is equal to 2E. So according to definition of pitch factor, Kp will be equal to 2E cos zeta by 2 divided by 2E is equal to cos zeta by 2. Therefore the formula for pitch factor is equal to cos zeta by 2. Let us now discuss winding factor. Winding factor is basically the ratio of EMF generated in a short pitch distributed coil to the EMF generated in a concentrated coil. It is denoted by Kw. Here note that we need to calculate two different things to get the value of winding factor. First one is EMF generated in short pitch distributed coil, and second one is EMF generated in a concentrated coil. As we know that EMF generated in a coil having n number of turns is given as E equal to root over 2 pi KpKd Fn phi, where Kp and Kd are the pitch factor and distribution factors respectively, whereas EMF generated in a concentrated coil having n number of turns is given as E dash is equal to root 2 pi Fn phi. Therefore, from the definition of winding factor, if we calculate the ratio of EMF generated in short pitch distributed winding and EMF generated in a concentrated winding, then the value of Kw will comes to be Kp into Kd. So from this formula of winding factor, we can define winding factor in other words, like winding factor is the product of pitch factor and distribution factor. Winding factor for nth harmonics can also be calculated by calculating the pitch factor and distribution factor for nth harmonics. Therefore, winding factor for nth harmonics is equal to Kpn into Kdn. Thank you. Hope you understood winding factor and pitch factor. But if you have any doubt, don't forget to write in comment box. It will be my pleasure to answer your question. And don't forget to visit electricalbaba.com. Thank you.